Hello students, today I am going to start your grammar syllabus. As you can see on the screen that the grammar syllabus will include the following topics. Tenses, models, use of passive voice, subject verb conquered, reported speech, commands and requests, statements, questions, clauses, noun clauses, adverb clauses of condition and time, relative clauses, determiners, and prepositions. Okay, so let's start your grammar syllabus with tenses. So I'm going to introduce tenses in this video. So let's get started. Let us first read the following sentences. I write this letter to please you. So here students, write refers to present time. I write this letter to please you. So write refers to present time. So the verb which refers to be in present time, it can said to be in present tense. The verb or a verb which refers present time can said to be in present tense. In second one, I wrote the letter in his very presence. I wrote the letter in his very presence. So here student, wrote refers the past time. So this sentence can said to be in past tense. In the third one, I shall write a letter tomorrow. So shall write refers future time. So this sentence can said to be in future tense. So here we have discussed that a verb that refers to present time is said to be in present tense, as I write, I love. One more thing, students, here I must tell you, the word tense comes from the Latin tempus, which means time. Okay, the word tense comes from the Latin tempus, which means time. Further, we have discussed a verb that refers to past tense is said to be in past tense. A verb that refers to past time is said to be in past tense, as I wrote, I loved. Similarly, a verb that refers to future time is said to be in future tense. For example, I shall write, I shall love. A verb that refers to future time is said to be in future tense, as I shall write, I shall love. So we can conclude that thus there are three main tenses. According to time of action, we can categorize tenses in three main parts, in three main types. So tenses have three main forms: the present, the past, and the future. So tenses are of three types: the present, the past, the future. So thus there are three main tenses: the present, the past, the future. And one thing must be noted down here. Sometimes a past tense Sometimes a past tense may refer a present time, and a present tense may express future time. Yes, the sentence, the structure of sentence is in past tense, but it refers the present time. Similarly, the structure of a sentence is in present tense, but it refers future time. Okay, let's see the example. I wish I knew the answer. So, according to structure, it is in past tense, but this sentence means I'm sorry, I do not know the answer. So, which shows present time. So, let's wait till he comes. So, according to structure, it is present. It is present tense. But according to meaning, it is future tense. So, more such structures we will be discussing when we will be studying tenses individually. When one by one, I will explain all the tenses. So, I will explain more such sentences to you. Okay. So, let us read some more sentences. I love. So, it is simple present. I'm loving. It is present continuous. I have loved. It is present perfect. I have been loving. It is present perfect continuous. So, students, the verbs in all these sentences refer to the present time and are therefore they said to be in the present tense. In sentence 1, however, the verb shows that the action is mentioned simply without anything being said about the completeness or incompleteness of the action. In sentence 2, the verb shows that the action is mentioned as incomplete or continuous, that is, as still going on. In sentence 3, the verb shows that the action is mentioned as finished, complete, or perfect at the time of speaking. The tense of the verb in sentence 4 is said to be in present perfect continuous because the verb shows that the action is going on continuously and not completed at this present moment. So thus we see that the tense of a verb shows not only the time of an action or event, but also the state of an action referred to. So what we have discussed so far, according to that, the present tense has four forms as mentioned above. They are simple present, present continuous, present perfect continuous. So the present tense has four parts, four forms. Just as present tense has four forms, the past tense also has the following four forms. I loved, simple past. I was loving, past continuous. I had loved, past perfect. I had been loving, past perfect continuous. So we can say that just as present tense, the past tense also has the following four forms: simple past, past continuous, past perfect continuous. Similarly, the future tense has the following four forms: I shall will love, simple future. I shall will be loving, future continuous. I shall will have loved. Future perfect, I shall will have been loving. Future perfect, continuous. So yes, students, one thing you can see that here both helping verbs have been used, will and shall. So either we can use shall or will with ing, and with other subjects in future we use will. So we will be discussing more about these helping verbs when we will be discuss all the tenses individually. Okay, so let us continue. A verb agrees with its subject in number and person. So let us study the verb forms of various tenses. So let us study more examples of various tenses. Simple present tense, I speak, present continuous tense, I'm speaking. In simple present tense, you speak. In present continuous tense, you are speaking. In simple present tense, he speaks. In present continuous tense, he is speaking. In simple present tense, we speak. In present continuous tense, we are speaking. In simple present tense, they speak. In present continuous tense, they are speaking. So on, in present perfect tense, I have spoken. In present perfect continuous tense, I have been speaking. You have spoken, you have been speaking. He has spoken, he has been speaking. We have spoken, we have been speaking. They have spoken, they have been speaking. In simple past tense and past continuous tense, in simple past tense, I spoke. In past continuous tense, I was speaking. You spoke, you were speaking. He spoke, he was speaking. We spoke, we were speaking. They spoke, they were speaking. In past perfect tense, I had spoken. In past perfect continuous tense, I had been speaking. In past perfect tense, you had spoken. In past perfect continuous tense, you had been speaking. He had spoken, he had been speaking. We had spoken, we had been speaking. They had spoken, they had been speaking. In simple future tense, I shall will speak. In future continuous tense, I shall will be speaking. In simple future tense, you will speak. In future continuous tense, you will be speaking. He will speak, he will be speaking. We shall will speak, we shall will be speaking. They will speak, they will be speaking. In future perfect, I shall will have spoken. In future perfect continuous tense, I shall will have been speaking. In future perfect tense, I shall will have spoken. In future perfect continuous tense, I shall will have been speaking. In future perfect tense, you will have spoken. In future perfect continuous tense, you will have been speaking. So here we have discussed sentence structure of all 12 tenses. So more examples and more rules we will be discussing when we will be studying all these tenses in detail. Now it's your time. So do the exercises given. So I'm also going to upload this exercise on Snap homework. So must write this exercise in your notebook. okay, with answer. And in next video, I will discuss answer to all these sentences. Either I will be discussing in video or I will upload on Snap homework. Okay, students. Thank you. Bye-bye. See you in next video.